Hello and welcome to A to Z Retail. Today we're looking at the Chandler Fashion Square Mall, located in the East Valley of the Phoenix area. Right off the bat, it was great to see so many people in one place, under one roof, walking around, smiling and laughing without masks on. It's just a beautiful sight to see that we're finally in the end days of this pandemic and the restrictions. Don't you let them lead you on. Post-pandemic, Chandler Fashion Square Mall has been prospering. It's already added two new retail stores and retained most of its capacity. The new retail stores are Urban Outfitters and FYE, which is a sort of Funko Pop entertainment collectibles store. And also a Cooper Hawk winery and restaurant will open just outside the mall later this fall. There's even a new kiosk selling popcorn called Doc Popcorn, which opened this spring as well. We'll have to try that out next time. Often it's hard to find many things to talk about with a prosperous mall like Chandler Fashion Square because there's not much criticism in the news media, and really in general, even when you visit with your own eye test, everything seems to be great and you're kind of just glad to walk around in the positive ambiance. However, I did find something that's noteworthy in the news, and it was by an ASU professor who is a retail expert. And they were talking about how Chandler Fashion Square is a great example of a mall that is adapting itself gradually into a more experience-based model. Now, what this means is, instead of just the traditional 70s, 80s shopping-centered mall, the focus is experience. And right here on the left, you can see the Crayola Creative Center, which is sort of like a Build-A-Bear activity place for kids to come and do specific activities. And I think this is a great example of how malls can succeed in the future. Obviously, there'll still be retail and shopping. Obviously, there's still going to be a food court because kids want to buy things and they also want to eat things, and so do parents. But I do think that for malls to survive, this ASU professor is right. They need experiences that draw them to the mall in the first place. Because for most people, it's easier to just sit online or drive to the strip mall and park in front of the store where they specifically want an item and then go home. I think the way to draw people into indoor malls specifically is these experientials. And we already saw two of them, the Crayola Creative Center and also that bungee jumping situation we just passed by in the beginning of the video. Currently, there are two missing anchors from this store, and that is the former Sears and also the former Nordstrom, which just closed in May 2020. Prior to the pandemic, Harkins was planning on opening a two-story entertainment concept in that location that previously housed Sears. I'm not sure exactly what that was and what it was supposed to be. It was not known publicly. But apparently nothing is off the table and there's still a possibility for it. Harkins hasn't commented exactly even what that might be, like whether it's just another movie theater, but that probably wouldn't make sense because they actually have a movie theater in this same lot. So maybe they wanted to branch out themselves and be less movie theater dependent and create some kind of Dave and Buster style entertainment center. Regardless, it seems that that idea has probably been shelved for good because with Nordstrom closing, a Midwest-based sports goods seller called Scheels is taking over the former Nordstrom lease, and it's expected to open its doors in the fall of 2023. It's an entertainment big store that is kind of sprouting out rapidly throughout the country, and it's going to feature a 16,000 gallon saltwater aquarium with over 600 fish and interactive arcade games, a wildlife mountain, and a cafe that serves gourmet sandwiches and soups, homemade fudge, and specialty coffee. So it seems like within the mall, there's going to be an entertainment center within itself. And it's also going to be great for the Phoenix economy. The Chandler store, they're planning to employ approximately 400 associate employees. One of the things I appreciate about Chandler Fashion Square Mall versus Scottsdale Fashion Square Mall is they kept the rustic Arizona color scheme. They kept that tan sandstone tile feature, and also the walls and the columns. A lot of them keep that kind of tan sandy color, which is sort of what I grew up on in Arizona. Almost every building had that color. And it's kind of been a shame to see everything, not just in Arizona, but throughout the entire country and probably most of the Western world, adopting the white color scheme for everything, white and silver color scheme. And while I understand the science behind it, that it makes spaces feel more open and inviting and bigger, I do think that it's nice to see this mall keep at least a main portion of its scheme sticking to the Arizona tradition and kind of keeping that Arizona vibe. Reality is, you just don't see this kind of color scheme in most places, and you especially don't see those stacked stone columns in many places in the world, and you know, in Europe or in the eastern United States. And so it's great to see them at least keep some of that traditional Arizona mall vibe, while Fashion Square Scottsdale has completely abandoned it for the most part, and with its recent remodeling, it's just become an entire white mausoleum. And I don't know, I understand that there's the science behind it, and that it's kind of what everybody wants with their houses and all of that, but it is nice to see a mall keep at least some of that, while also modernizing it with the white features. In every video, I'm trying to have a little question for the comments, and I think a great one here is, what is your favorite mall food? And that can be food court, or it can be like a kiosk snack pretzels thing. Personally, if I'm going to a mall, 90% of the time when I get food, it's gonna be Wetzel's pretzels. It's probably the first time I smell it, I'm like a dog, and I just gotta go over there and get those pretzel bites. It's just irresistible to me, especially because you can't really get them anywhere else but in the mall. That's my case. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. This lemonade store caught my eye next to the GameStop. I wonder how good it is. Speaking of Wetzel's Pretzels earlier, I love their lemonade, but you know, I don't mind having a little competition, especially in the summer in Arizona. Nothing beats a nice cold lemonade. We'll be right back. Here's another general question about mall shopping that I have for the comments. What do you go to the mall to buy? What brings you to a mall? I know many people that probably bother to watch a video like this like going to the mall, at least for walking around. But maybe that's all you do. Maybe you don't really like to shop at the mall. Maybe you like to just do mall walking. I don't know. Personally, few times I buy things from the mall, from actual retail stores, it's maybe like an H&M or like a clothing item or two. Maybe, probably most often it's for shoe shopping if I need to buy a new pair of sneakers. Personally, I do think that one of the negative things about the mall is that it really is kind of wasteful. You know, do we really need so many retail stores selling the same kind of fast fashion items? Probably not, but I do think that doesn't mean that the mall itself is a waste. Like we said before, I think the experiential element is a big player for the future. But I also think that maybe we'll see spaces become different and more activities. Like maybe, you know, if you go on Groupon, you'll see those like things girls like to do, like go to some painting class and drink wine. It'd be kind of cool to have little things like that inside of mall spaces, and just little small activities that maybe you buy some things, but then you also do an activity there. I do think that really is a great idea for a future mall, and it's something that really needs to be indoors in Arizona, because nobody wants to walk around and browse shopping from a strip mall perspective. It's just so hot. It's just so unbearably hot. Apparently, Chandler Fashion Square Mall is partnering with local East Valley and Arizona artists and creators to have a pop-up artisan market at the mall. I'm not sure when and where that takes place, but wasn't there the day we were there, and I'd like to see it sometime. So if anyone knows more about that, let us know. Anyways, it was a great experience to go to a thriving mall, unlike Arizona or Mercado Center, where we couldn't even find more than 5 people walking around. It was just amazing to see a thriving mall in the middle of the Arizona summer, which is where people need to be. People need to be inside of air-conditioned malls. Nobody wants to go to strip malls in Arizona in July, okay? California developers, figure that one out, please. So as long as Chandler Fashion Square and Scottsdale Fashion Square and Arrowhead and the other successful indoor malls continue to be successful, I'm hoping that this entertainment experiential model might bring back a resurgence of indoor malls, at least in the Valley. Let us know in the comments. Thank you for your appreciation, and we'll see you next time. Goodbye.